Contact!
Wrong move. Ow. Ow. Hello there.
No, think about the CO2 emissions.
It's me, the Terminator.
I could just shoot you now, you know.
I forgot about the minigun. Oops.
Wow, I am bad at this. How do I keep missing you? Am I the Terminator or she the Terminator? Target will not die! Ah, yes. Casually hold on to my 181 kilograms of weight. No, drugs, winners, don't use drugs! I sleep now. Goodbye. Fooled you. Press the power button. Your shoelace is untied. Let me help you with it. Come on, let me help you. I will see you in your dark fate. Yay, a new Terminator series, and it's not total garbage. This one does what I wanted more series to do. Just place a story in the Terminator world without reinventing everything. The story revolves around Malcolm Lee, a scientist trying to save humanity from its dark fate. Other important characters are his kids, his Japanese maid, and of course, the Terminator, and the woman that stands atop him from the future. In all seriousness, the animation is very good. Not the best I've seen, but you can easily see the influence from Ghost in the Shell, because it does come from some of the same people who made the original. The story is alright, but the characters are not focused on enough. For example, the core of the plot is Malcolm talking to his AI girlfriend about humanity not deserving to die. Then the Terminator is hunting him and his kids, so the future badass warrior woman is here to help. Like in the first movie, and in the second movie, and in every other movie. Without spoiling too much, I do like the characters, but I would have liked to have more time with them, so to more easily terminate them. Malcolm is pretty much the only one with a defined character arc. His kids are mostly just kids, and the future badass warrior woman is not focused on enough. And on that side, neither is the Terminator. My main issue with the show is the lack of depth for most of the characters, the very small amount of Terminator scenes, and a lot of the action scenes not making sense. For example, a human cannot fucking move a Terminator. The Terminator E-800 weighs about 181 kilograms or 400 pounds, and you cannot take hits from it on your spine. Some plot armor needs to exist, but you cannot have the main character tanking hits from a Terminator when he kills everybody else in one shot. The ending is of course a cliffhanger, and we will get more seasons, not sure how many, but hopefully they finish up the plot properly. But there's one thing I would like more, the one thing missing from every Terminator movie. More stuff in the future, more of the future war. The only movie that has this is the one with Christian Bale, and it was nothing special, unfortunately. In the normal timeline, this show would be just okay. But with the recent Terminator movies being shit, this is the best piece of Terminator fiction you will get for a while. Here is waiting for the next season.